Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Miss Unbreakable Timeline, and in this video I'm going to be showing you guys how you can get the same bantu knots on 4B/4C hair type with using no heat at all. So let's get right into it. So the first thing that you will need is a comb, and I love to use a rat tail comb because of the rat tail, which is the pointy part at the end. And I'm starting off in the back of my hair because that's just what I prefer. You can start off in the front. And when I was starting to do my hair, I was like, you know what, let me record this for you guys. So that's why that part was already done. And I am parting that section into only two, and I know I parted it at an angle because that's how I wanted it to be. So now I'm just going to take scrunchies, that way it can hold the hair into place and hold your ponytails. So as you guys see, I'm just putting that left side up in a ponytail so it won't get in the way of my ponytail on the right side. Now before we go into doing our ponytails, you guys must detangle your hair, especially if it has not been washed yet like mine's. I love to detangle my hair first. Y'all know how I am. If you see my other hair videos, I always detangle my hair first. And then I'm going to take some edge control. You can use any edge control you like. I love to use the brand Even, and then I'm just going to place that edge control around the perimeter of a part. And I'm going to take a edge and comb brush just because I want that part to be laid down really, really smooth. So that's why I'm taking this little brush to do that first. And then I'll take a bigger bristle brush just to really brush all of that into place and into a ponytail. Now the reason why I slowed this part down, because I wanted you guys to see that I am using scrunchies for my ponytails and not rubber bands, is because I don't want the rubber bands to pull on my hair, especially when I take it out. So that's why I'm using scrunchies, and I'm not having that ponytail so tight, because you don't want to like go to sleep and your head is hurting and you get a headache. Trust me, you don't want that. So it might look a little tight, but it's really not. So now I'm doing the middle section of my hair, and this section will have three parts in it. Now remind you guys, I am doing this by myself, as you guys can see, so your parts do not have to be perfect. They were almost perfect until I got to the middle and my hair was just too tangled. So that's why the part wasn't so straight, which is fine. I do need a good wash, and I wanted to do this hairstyle before I washed my hair because I knew I was putting all this edge control in my hair and it was gonna be dirty anyways. And besides, I was just doing this hairstyle for a like little photo shoot that I was doing. So yeah, my hair does need to be washed. So before I part my hair, I must detangle that section really well. And I wanted this section of my hair to be more at like a triangle look instead of like a box look. So that's why I parted the way that I did. Now before I finish off the little bit that I have left in the back, I'm going to start parting the front because I just want to see how many more bantu knots I will need in the back. So I'm parting on the right side of my hair first, and I want to make sure the front parts of my hair is straight. Now I'm a perfectionist when it comes to like my hair, especially in the front, because I could see the front, and I want those parts to look really nice. So, and as you guys can see, I'm like scratching my dandruff because my hair is really dry and I have dry scalp. So now I'm just going to take that edge control and put that around the perimeter of that box part, whatever you guys want to call it, and do the same thing that I did to the back of my hair. So first I want to make sure that my edges are out because I don't want those to be brushed back and too tight in the ponytail already. So I'm making sure that is out of the way first. And then as you guys see, I took out that ponytail because it was too far back and I didn't want it that far back looking. So I took it out and redid it. Now I'm going to go in with braiding hair, and the braiding hair that I choose is the pre-stretched braiding hair. And as you guys will see, first I will start braiding the braiding hair with my real hair, and I'm not putting that braiding hair over that scrunchie. I'm starting right at the top where my hair is like loose at, and then I'm braiding it. Then I will start two strand twisting the hair together, and then at the end I would just twist it like in one little big twist. So it's like three different techniques in one little bantu knot. But I did it this way for a reason, because I wanted my bantu knots to be put. So that's why I started off braiding it first, and then I'll twist it, and then I'll do two strand twists, and then I'll do the one big twist. And you guys will see the reason why. I can't really explain it, but it looks just a lot neater like that. And that's why I like to use the pre-stretched hair, is because now the ends are not like a blunt cut to where I would have had to put edge control at the end just to keep the hair in place. So that's why I like the pre-stretch, because I can just wrap the loose ends around that bantu knot. And it's okay if the bantu knot keep unraveling, that's fine. I'm not like a professional hairstylist, so I'm just explaining you guys how I did it. And yeah, I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, you guys, at all, as long as they look like bantu knots. But like I said, I like my hairstyles to kind of look perfect, especially if I'm doing it by myself. And I will secure the bantu knots by putting a rubber band around it. And with the rubber bands, I don't wrap it around more than once, only put it on there, like literally just put the rubber band around the bantu knots without wrapping it like twice or a third time. So yeah, you guys, you'll want to do the same thing for all of your bantu knots. So before I finish off the middle of my hair, only did like two bantu knots in the middle, I'm going to do my edges, because I wanted the front of my hair completely done. So that's all I'm doing, you guys. I'm still using the even edge control. I like using this because it doesn't leave like a white cast on my hair. So this even looks perfect on hair, on natural hair. It doesn't leave it white or anything like that. And you guys gotta remember, my hair is not gonna look super straight or sleek looking when it's in these bantu knots, because I am natural and I didn't put any heat on it. But once you put a edge wrap around your edges and let them sit for a while, it's gonna look perfect. And you guys will see, or you've seen in the beginning, how perfect they look. So yeah, you guys, I hope you guys really enjoy this hair tutorial. Please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. I'm hoping you liked it. I think you liked it. But yeah, until next time, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.